hear you.
Okay, she's a 25-year-old female with complaints of severe dysmenorrhea, dysgeusia, severe menorrhagia with irregular menses and chronic pelvic pain. She's a nulli gravida with primary infertility for 6 years. In 2016, she underwent a laparoscopy where bilateral chocolate cysts were drained with adhesiolysis. In 2020, she underwent a second laparoscopy in view of bilateral tubo-ovarian mass with frozen pelvis. The case was abandoned and declared inoperable, and the patient was referred to Mayflower Hospital. On examination, her pervaginal findings were retroverted adenomyotic bulky uterus with restricted mobility and puckering of the vagina and a localized posterior wall adenoma. On per-rectal examination, there was a 2.5 into 2 cm endometriotic nodule felt at rectosigmoid junction at 11 o'clock position, and the rectal mucosa was free. On USG, she had a bulky uterus, adenomyotic, which was acutely retroverted with lacunae collection in posterior myometrium. She has a left-sided tubo-ovarian mass adherent to posterior surface of the uterus with left-sided axis deviation. Her bladder is adherent to the anterior uterine wall up to the fundus and colon adherent posteriorly. She has a left-sided pelvic kidney. On MRI, she has a retroverted adenomyotic uterus showing few ill-defined hypo-intense area in the fundus and posterior wall, a localized adenoma with loss of endometrial differential and thickening of junctional zone, left ovarian endometrioma with hematosalpinx, a colorectal nodule of 2.5 into 1.5 cm infiltrating in the muscularis portion of the colon. She has a left ectopic kidney at L5 S1 level with renal hilum facing anteriorly, dilated pelvic calcium system with possibility of PUJ obstruction. On CT IVP, she has an ectopic pelvic left kidney with calculus in lower pole calyx and partial PUJ obstruction. Normally excreting unobstructed right kidney.
If I can please interrupt, can we move on with the physical work, because it's only 1 hour 15 minutes.
Rajesh, can you hear me?
Yes.
Can I start this one?
Yes, sir. Please, sir.
Rajesh, if you look my video.
Yes, we can see this.
This is the pelvic kidney at the level of symphysis pubis.
Yes.
At the level of the L5 and S1. This is the bulge here. And second important part here, this one is the uterus is acutely retroverted. The bladder is here. We couldn't even visualize properly the uterus. Here is the densely colon is adherent here. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes.
Okay, so our Meiji cap, we start from the here. Even though this one is the pelvic kidney, we take care related to ureter. And sometimes we find out the abnormal pathway of the ureter. So I think here it's the dense colonic adhesions. Previously this one is operated two times.
Are basically because of the previous two times that she has been operated for endometriosis that you have these fibrous colonic adhesions over here.
Yes, it's maybe surgical adhesions we kept in our mind. But here this one is dense because in the first endoscopy somebody is only the drain here. And this is the area. Can you appreciate? This is the peritoneum here. This is the fat of the colon. Can you appreciate?
Yes,
picture is quite clear.
Yes.
And I try to make the rub with this one. Even though here again with me, Dr. Laxman Kheria with me is our heading the GID department. And my chief anesthetist is Dr. Sanjeev Upadhyay. This is the area of the TO mass. Can you appreciate?
Yes.
So I think I try to make the mobilize the colon first because I couldn't visualize the anything, even though not the tip of the. Here again I go back because this patient is obese. So inner fat mass is also more. This is the area of the peritoneum reflexions. So again I enter into this area. This is the lot of fibrosis is here. Can you appreciate?
Yes.
And this is the whole chunk of TO mass. Further I move forward, here. I try to make the dissect. I dissected lateral fat, okay? And here this is the area of the bladder.
Yes.
This is the whole different area. Again, I move here because I try to make the mobilize the colon is very important part. If I couldn't properly mobilize the colon, then it's very difficult in such kind of the cases.
Jai Bhai, Dr. Krishna Kumar here.
Very, very good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Fantastic case.
I use this case intensely because this is associated with the pelvic kidney and previously 2 times operated and also the conservative surgery.
I personally
believe that conservative surgery is much more complicated than the radical. Now I forget the plane of cleavage. Can you appreciate?
Yeah, very nice.
So I think it's very important
very nice.
To understand related to this part. And I think Rajesh, Jyoti and
Nagendra
is the...
Nagendra, yes sir. Yes, I am there, sir.
So this is the another area. Again, I cut it. I go inside. Yeah. I try to make the straight little bit. Can you appreciate?
Yes.
Sometimes I try to make the get the advantage of the elasticity of the tissue. Okay. Here it's the also the dense adhesion. So furthermore, I go toward here because very important. Even in the morning, office is telling take care related to bladder in such kind of the cases. Dr. Deepak has operated this case. Here is also the bladder is very close to this one. Can you appreciate?
Yes, this is the part.
Even though this is the area of the round ligament, this is the whole chunk of the TO mass is behind to the this one.
So you're using a suprapubic port, the third.
No, I think I am through the umbilicus. I always love to use the through the umbilicus, and again the Lakshman is little bit give the stretch. I little bit
asking.
Here. This is the rectal tube. Can you appreciate?
Yes.
And
sir,
this is the this fat is different
port.
From the this fat. This is the bladder fat.
Okay,
so you understand the texture of the tissue is also very important. Furthermore, I dissected, I stretched this one. Can you appreciate now?
Yeah.
Yes.
Jai,
yes.
Your identification and explanation of tissue is always fantastic.
Sir.
People appreciate
here,
the
I now feel the tactile surface. This is the most probably the doom of the uterus. Okay. Now again, further I came forward here. Here, this is the also colonic adhesion at the fundus.
Yes.
Due to the pelvic kidney, sometime we couldn't get the good view, and that's why the umbilicus is better in the such kind of the cases. This is the fallopian tube. Can you appreciate? I get
yes.
the body feeling.
Yes.
So texture is very important part. This is the boggy feeling, and this is the I feel the hardness. This is the doom of the uterus. This is the fallopian tube.
Dr. Patel, sir, has there any bowel preparation been done? Any special bowel preparation?
I think, particularly in this case, because we give the pig leg.
Yeah.
This is the also TO mass. Most probably, I feel that this is the simple follicular cyst, and also I try to take care to avoid the leave the remnant ovarian tissue. Okay. But in this case, we remove the TO mass on the left side because it's the pelvic kidney associated with the 2-time development. Here. Now we appreciate.
Yes.
This is the fallopian tube, okay? And here, this is the chunk of the fat.
Are you manipulating the uterus?
It's not possible, even though dilatation is little bit difficult in these cases.
So are you manipulating the uterus from below?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Because right now it's not possible because it's acutely retroverted, and sometimes we try to make the even the manipulate it maybe create the problem. So the first step to we get the view. If we couldn't look it, we couldn't enter it. Okay.
Yes.
So I think the most important part to you get the view. Now I get, this is the, I think, hard tissue. This is most probably, and I try to make the flush to the uterus. Okay?
Yes.
Can you appreciate now?
Absolutely, sir. Wonderful.
So this is the one of the approach we created. You get the feel of the tissue. You get the tactile tissue. You understand the texture, and gradually you enter it. This is the this is the fact. Okay.
What do you think is the role of using vasopressin in the uterus to prevent the backflow?
Definitely I prefer to use the infiltrate the vasopressin, but yet now we couldn't get the space and we couldn't visualize the uterus. Now I feel that this is the uterus, and it's the whole uterus is deviated on the one side.
Would you infiltrate vasopressin in the adhesions before starting your dissection?
No, but I definitely prefer to use the infiltrate the pitrocin. Again, yes, I look here. Again, I look here on the this way.
Are you giving any hypotensive anesthesia in
a case? I think we prefer to use sometimes the spinal with GA.
Okay.
In such kind of the cases.
So in this particular case, what is the BP right now?
It's 94 by 50.
So systolic 100 is.
Is that?
I also prefer quite often.
Yes.
That
it definitely gives a lot of advantage.
Yeah.
And now I spoke with the, here also there is a, I get the space. Sometimes I tear the tissue because it's you get the advantage of the this one. And look here, this is the whole uterus. Lakshmi. Now I get the visualize. This is the fundus of the uterus. This is the part of the TO mask. Can you appreciate?
Yes, sir.
Very nicely.
And one important part, whenever you couldn't get the space, you go for the debulking. So this is the one of the principle and dictum we created in the at Mayflower Hospital, because in such kind of the cases we need to the space. So we also go for the debulking of the such kind of the cases. Hello.
Can you repeat the dictum, Dr. Patel? What is the dictum?
Debulking surgery. If this one is the big chocolate cyst, we drain it. So we get the little bit space. Okay.
Yes. Yes. Dictum.
So you prefer keeping a gauze rather than a suction all
yes,
the time?
Yes, yes. Always, because gauze is much more better. Sometimes you put the excessive lavage is also create the problem. This is the, now I try to make the little bit dilated the uterus, and this is the area of the whole part of the fibrosis, okay? This is the part of the nodules. Can you appreciate? This is the white lesions. Now further we move here, because this is kidney, very important to be, we save the, ureter. So if you need a little bit patience, if you understand the principle, we develop the mathematics in the endometriosis surgery. And if you stuck with the same mathematics, majority time you get the good plane of TBS. Okay? Now
Sanjay,
this is
yes,
the
yes.
this is
no.
the pelvic kidney. Can you appreciate? Pakad jo isko aisa karo. The my main motto.
This went down a little bit, so you need to talk a little closer to the mic.
Now my main motto, to we enter in the middle pararectal space, and also very important to identify the ureter and infundibulopelvic. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Here this is the absolutely altered anatomy. So sometimes it's very difficult. You need a lot of patience, try to make the understand. And now I show you, Rajendra, this is the peritoneal surface. Can you appreciate
yes,
this one?
Yes, absolutely.
So this
absolutely.
Is the
wonderful.
Size of the ovary. Most probably,
yes.
it's the part of the ovary. Okay?
Yes.
This is the white structure, and with the peritoneal thickening with the different vascularity. Here vascularity is different, here is different. Most probably this is the
think
part
the
of the infundibular pelvic.
Yep. Then now it's okay.
So this is the TO mass associated with the, and here I go down. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes, sir.
I
yes,
stress
sir.
The tissue. I try to make the perpendicular to the, this one. Here, this is the nodules, blackening of the nodules with the hard tissue. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, this is the nodule part. I cut it. Sometimes I prefer to split the nodules. It's also very important
okay.
in such kind of the cases.
Is this the bowel lumen which is in the right hand or is this the right side assistant is pulling?
So I think this is the area of the middle pararectal space. Can you appreciate?
Yes,
this
sir.
Is the,
yes, sir.
Now again I go at the level of what I am telling. This is the different vascularity. This is the infundibulopelvic. Okay.
Yes,
okay.
sir. Yes, sir.
Again I try to make the mobilized little bit fat.
wouldn't you like to go to the promontory level and then locate the ureter, sir?
Yes, it's very important because here is the pelvic kidney. Jyoti, I show you previously, this is absolutely pelvic kidney. So identification of ureter is very important in such kind of the cases. Again, I mobilize the colon. This is very important. Let's put it. It's a wrong one. So this is the psoas muscles. This is the infundibular pelvic, okay? I try to make the exposed much more because here the abnormal course of the ureter. Can you appreciate? And this is the whole chunk of the infundibulum. Different vessels here, okay? Facet is obese. And this is the external iliac artery. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So my ureter is always, whatever the abnormality, it's medial to this one. Medial to the infundibulum. Okay? Leave it. Again, I go real to the middle parietal space because here this one is the kidney. Okay?
Yes.
And if you lift up this one, there CO2 is entered. And it gives the demarcated line between the middle parietal, whatever the abnormality. Okay?
Yes, sir. Yes.
This is the part of the kidney. Okay, can you appreciate? This is the kidney. Can you appreciate? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. It is very much visible.
So I try to make the dissect furthermore. I enter in the retroperitoneal again. Very gently. Sometimes it creates the trauma to the kidney and it creates the problem. Again, I try to make the stretch this one. We enter in the retroperitoneal and try to make the find out the ureter.
That's the kidney, sir.
Yes. It's extending, its bulge is from here to the here. Okay?
Okay.
From
okay,
here to the here.
Yes.
And sometimes it's the hypertrophic kidney.
It has some micronephrosis, probably bad question.
And this is the area of the teomas. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes. Yes.
And this is the small cyst is here. So we enter into this area. This here we couldn't find out the ureter because it's the level of the above the level of peritoneum. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So here I am don't worry related to this part. Further we more dissected here. This is the nodules. I split it. Can you appreciate? This is the white lizard, this is the nodules, okay?
Yes,
sir. He's about. This is the nodules. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes, yes, yes.
I go by fiber by fiber. This is very important in such kind of the surgery. You go by fiber by fiber. Now again my next step to mobilize the bladder. Before that, I try to make the find out the ureter because it's the very short ureter and its kidney is extended up to the pelvis. So very important, before I remove the teomas, always I prefer to look for the ureter.
I think this should be a rule in every, this is a case of pelvic kidney, but otherwise also in such adherent masses, localizing the ureter in the beginning is
sometimes the course of the ureter may be changed due to the pelvic kidney. So try to make the identify the ureter as far as possible, because one is the dictum is that ureter is going here, okay, not going here, because this is the colon. So always try to make the find out the ureter at the level of this one. Sometimes if you feel the any difficulty, I go retroperitoneal and try to make the find out the ureter. Okay? Because one of the landmark we utilize is the uterine artery. Water is always the below the bridge.
Yes.
Here this one is the dense adhesions. Now I go retroperitoneal. I little bit confused, so again I come back. Maybe ureter is here. I don't know exactly because the course of the ureter I couldn't identify. still I again look here, because majority time we identify the ureter at the level of pelvic rim.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
But this case, it's absolutely different one. So I, this is the whole area of the external iliac artery. Now I try to make the look here. This is the external iliac
artery
or vein. This is the common iliac artery. This is the external. This is the internal iliac. And maybe this is the renal artery. Can you appreciate this one is this is the renal artery. Okay?
Yes, sir.
This is the renal artery.
Yes.
So further we look here. We try to make the stage. Before that, we again go to the retroperitoneal. Okay? That's what I think.
Yes, sir.
Really challenging because the kidney is occupying all the space at the brim.
Yes, but you, before you remove the TO mass, you look the ureter, it's the addictive. Barabar?
Yes.
Yes.
I try to make the do the parallel to the infant below.
Yes, sir.
This is the, all the fibrotic peritoneum, okay? Even the harmonic is couldn't work properly.
Sir, do pre-op stenting help in such cases?
I think it's. I never believe in the pre-op stenting if because it's lost the elasticity of the tissue, and second, sometimes it creates the iatrogenic injury of the ureter. So I think if any doubt, then later on definitely we do the stenting. If any doubt, so rather than the pre-op, always prefer to. This is the whole TO mass with the inflammatory process. Can you appreciate? This is all fibrotic peritoneum over it. Gradually, I try to make the. And try to make the remove in bulk and block. Okay, it's very important.
Okay.
This is the whole TO mass. Second important part, most probably with the pelvic kidney, even though the uterine artery landmark is never changed. Okay, so we look, sometimes if we felt the difficulty, then the Sandesh is telling, always you look for the internal iliac artery. Okay, so. This patient is obese, sometimes the fat mass is much more higher.
Very nice and very fast surgical dissection, Dr. Sanjay. It's really nice.
So I think good. It's
simply amazing.
It's this is the case, I think there is this is the external iliac, this is the anterior division of the umbilical, okay? So I think still the uterine artery is displaced maybe medially. So we further more dissected here. This is the fibrotic. So again, we further more dissected here because we already exposed the common iliac vessels. We try to make the flush to the, this one and look here. Okay? This is the. Internal iliac, most probably. I take care for the small blizzard because it's staining of the tissue, then it's also create the problem. So this is the, even the look that the internal iliac artery is stretched like anything in this case, okay?
Yes.
Also we take care related to superior vesical artery. So this is the whole length of the internal iliac artery. Can you appreciate?
Yes, sir.
So this is the internal iliac vein. Can you appreciate? This is blue color.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
But it's the length is quite big. I try to make the dissect parallel to the this one. most probably this is the uterine artery.
Yes.
Yeah, the horizontal structure.
But this is the also abnormal course. What I feel that majority cases, I think we find out the good bipolar. I dissected furthermore this tumors. Bipolar. So, little bit staining, I try to make the clear it. Here, this is the kalu pacho jato kalu. I think we felt the some difficulty. We felt the some difficulty because due to the pelvic kidney, we couldn't visualize properly. This is the uterine artery. Can you appreciate?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's the abnormal course with the vein. Okay? So my target to find out the ureter, it's below to the this one. Okay?
So in this case, we are going with the known landmarks and retrospectively.
This is the absolutely, if you look that, this is the whole. If you look the internal iliac artery, it's so stretched here, okay? Mm. And this is the uterine artery, this is the superior vesical artery here. Can you appreciate?
Yes.
This is the superior vesical artery. This is the area also further you more dissected because we want to see the ureter. This is very important in such kind of the cases. Don't jump directly. Otherwise, you end up with the major problem.
Yes, sir.
Okay? So now my next target to identify the ureter, water is always the below the beach. Let's we, I think, find out because sometimes it's very difficult in such cases to identify the ureter. Even though we do the lot of jugglery in such kind of the cases. Again, we come back here. We also check it. So further I more dissect because I need the space. Always I am telling, do the debulking, create the space, because without creating the space sometimes it's very difficult. So I further mobilize the tumors. Okay?
Yes, sir.
But definitely we find out it, no problem. Okay? This is the whole tumors. Yes, and this is the bladder is adherent here. Okay, we do the mobilization of bladder. This is the round ligament puckering. Can you appreciate?
Yes, sir.
And now you look, the fibria is pop out.
Yes, sir.
This is the whole tumor is buried inside. This is lacunae collections, what the MRI people is telling, associated with the sixth wall. This is the all active endometriotic gland. Are you appreciate?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Rajesh, any comment? Most welcome.
It's amazing. It's simply amazing, sir.
It's actually a very good surgery, clear picture. Your sound is also coming through properly and the surgical dissection concepts are very nice. It's easy to notice that you are able to get into the correct tissue dissection plane very easily. And I think that is really relevant to be able to
and
get
now
into the
this is the
plane.
Whole diverted, Rajesh, this is the whole diverted uterus, okay?
Yes, sir.
Never jump here, because if you jump here, it hurts the myometrium tissue.
Yeah. Okay? Where do we see the normal ovarian tissue in this? How do we consider
it? I use the here. I think most probably there is a no ureter, so I think I try to make the do the debulking surgery. Before that, I check is look here. Lakshmani, I very carefully because kidney is here, so there is a no sense to. I think ureter is here. Okay.
Sir, Das Patel, sir.
I think kidney is here. Okay, so in the this infundibulum, most probably there is a no ureter, but still I check it. But I think most probably nothing is remain inside. Again, I am the more important related to think for the ureter rather than the other part.
Sir, will we be able to conserve some ovarian tissue in this woman?
No,
she
I think this case is for the removal of the tumors. Because one important part, patient is also understand the severity and graveness of this disease. Patient is very educated, patient is know everything, and she also feel that if I preserve this ovary on this side, there is ample of chances of the victim of the ureter. Because ureter is the first victim, Jyoti. Okay, it's the thinnest portion, very close to this one. and ureter is the first victim. Still, I think this is the fundus of the uterus is here. Okay. I try to make the remove this one and look here. Furthermore, because this is the ovarian ligament, still is the uterus is behind to the this one, and this is the bladder area. And Nagendra, might be you know that
yes,
we
sir.
Done the one case like this one of the bladder endometrioma.
Yes, I remember very much, sir.
So this is the same case like this one, but the approach is little bit different due to the pelvic kidney.
Yes. So that case we had the bladder endometrioma extending over the uterine, left ureter and back onto the rectum like a coma.
Yes.
I still remember that, very interesting.
And this is the whole teomas. So reversely I do this dissection, okay?
Yes, sir.
This is
yes,
the ovarian involvement. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And most probably, now this is the right time. Further, we look the ureter. Barabar, because we are near to the here. Maybe the ureter is here. Okay. So further, we look the ureter. Maybe displaced with the colon.
Why don't you detach the mass completely and then look?
I think this is the one thing we kept in our mind. But I think exposure of this one.
Do you think the ureter glow system would be of benefit in a case like this?
Sometimes, Rajesh, I personally feel that this such kind of this fancy instrument maybe create the problem. I try to make the flush to this one. Okay, I understand this is the part of the ovarian ligament. Okay. And I flush to the teomas, so most probably there is less chances of the injury of the ureter. This is the sum of the principle you created in the such kind of the surgery, and I try to make the detect from the here. Okay, this is the ovarian ligament. Can you appreciate?
Yes, sir.
Because this is the axis rotation of the whole uterus, and this is the fallopian tube. What I am cutting.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I am cutting the fallopian tube. This is ovarian ligament. Further, I come up. Okay. I leave the sum of the nodules here. I remove this one. Okay. This is the whole teomas. This is not kidney. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now I clean it. I took the gauze piece.
Really excellent dissection.
Further, I try to make the dissect the here because this is maybe adhesions, colonic adhesions. I try to make the clear it. Might be we get the good plane and we mobilize further colon. This is the area of denominus fascia. Okay, can you appreciate?
Yes, sir.
This is the two layer of denominus fascia. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Further, I have Dr. Lakshman with me. So maybe the ureter may be here in this zone, but before that, we try to make the again like break this one. So you need a lot of patience in such kind of the cases. This is ovarian ligament, okay? Thinking of the ovarian ligament. This is the whole chunk. This is the middle pararectal space. Okay?
Yes.
Okay, and this is the part of the nodules. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes, sir.
This is the part of the nodules. Can you appreciate? Okay?
Yes.
Further, we more move toward this one. We go in the this pararectal space here. Because we need to mobilize properly colon. Once we enter, we try to main. Majority time here is the dense adhesions. If you enter in the virgin area, this is the virgin area. And we also try to make the look for the obturator hypogastric nerve. Sorry.
Can we you lost your last sentence. You'll have to repeat that last sentence once.
This is the nerve sparing surgery. This is the hypogastric nerve. Can you appreciate?
This
is the fiber of this one.
Yes.
This is the nodules. Okay, what the MRI people is telling, this is the part of the nodules. Further, we more mobilize the colon. And this is the area. This is the puckering of the fat. What I am telling during the Rajesh workshop, if any time whorled appearances of the fat, that means is near to the nodules. Okay?
Yes.
So this is the area of the denominator fascia. Can you appreciate? Most probably,
yes.
I think everybody is agree with me.
Yes, we are the right thing.
And this is the part of the vagina, but I think we further not dissected much more here because our now Beji came to mobilize this one. Now this is the all implanted, okay? So we go further, we look related to this is the, maybe the ureter, we might be is the here in the this plane.
Pelvic kidney is sitting on the almost in the center.
In the center, Jyoti. So I think maybe with what we look on the other side, it's maybe this is the colon, okay? And maybe pelvic calysis, maybe axis rotation of the kidney on shifted on the one side. This is the area of the ideally the middle parietal space. Okay, this is the colonic area and this is the fibrotic vent. I cut it. Just I wait, I look that maybe it's the tube, okay? I go slowly, again further I look real. I enter into this area.
The areolar tissue is responding very nicely to Dr. Sanjay Patel.
Now this is the colon, okay? Can you appreciate, Rajesh?
Yes.
This is the colon, Lakshmani. And this is the part of the kidney, okay? So this is ideally our middle parietal space is here. Okay? And if you enter below to the this one, then you get the holy plane. Okay?
Yes.
But my Beji came to identify the ureter. Not other part. So that's why I dissected this one. Maybe axis rotate whole rotation of the kidney, and that's why I enter into this plane. Lakshman, isko dekhte hain, dekhte hain. Sometimes if this one is the adhesions with the rectum, I don't bother for that. I suture it. Okay.
Yes.
Because whatever the way, I try to make the remove the all the endometriotic tissue. Okay. Now this is the my cleaning of the. This is the area of the lateral approach. What we do in the bowel resections. Okay. And this is the whole rectovaginal plate. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes.
So also be removed later on. This is the rectal tube, okay?
You prefer putting a rectal probe here?
Now, yet not, I not put it. This is the rectal tube. Can you appreciate?
Yes.
And if I go above this one, This is the two layer of the fascia. This is the part of the vagina. Okay? So this is the whole rectum tube. I also checked very carefully here. This is small thermal injury, superficial. Okay, don't worry, we took the stitch later on, okay? But still this one is the preserving, this one. And now furthermore I dissected, this is the hypogastric nerve. Can you appreciate? This is the whole hypogastric nerve. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now again it's the focus is here. Okay? Further I try to make the open this one. Okay, put the check small neck over this one. Water is always below the beat, so we try to make the here. Again, I cut little bit. Parallel to the kidney, I try to make the open the peritoneum. This is the dense, leave it.
The MRI is the course of ureter visible.
I think
in the MRI?
Sometimes it's not easy, madam. What we feel that, I think in the pelvic kidney we realize because we do the. Look here on the other side. This most probably is the ureter. Okay? Most probably. But still need to we do the vitreous suture. Sometimes some tearing of the tissue, it's okay. Bipolar, chhod de lo. If needed, then you do the stenting again. Just we spend the some time, and if still is the we have the some doubt, the, then we put the J-stent. But now I do the focus related to bladder. Niche kar, Raj. Okay, this is the whole bulging. This is the whole bladder is adherent here.
Yes, sir.
It may be associated. Always try to make the do from the virgin area to the non-virgin area. This is the involvement of the bladder. Can you appreciate? This is active endometriotic gland. Okay?
Yes.
And try to make the flush to the this one. This is the virgin area, okay? The whole uterus is buried below the bladder. So this is the plane I want to get it for the bladder mobilization. This is all our involvement of the tissue. This is the round ligament, okay? And this is the, sometimes we go in the one layer of the uterus. This is very important to avoid the injury of the bladder.
Right.
Here, this is the nodules here. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes.
Further, this is the vascularity is different one. Can you understand, sir? This is the pseudo layering.
Yes.
This is the pseudo layering. We try to make the stretch this pseudo layering. Okay.
Yes.
Here, this is the we put the small neck. And this is the layer between the two layer of pubovesicles fascia. But before that, sometimes we fill up the bladder and we check the upper margin of the bladder. But I think in these cases, I am full confident, no problem, because we dealt with the such kind of the so many cases. Niche kar ultrasound. Dabao niche.
Very nicely dissected. Would you consider putting in a myoma screw in the uterus and lifting it up?
I personally not believe in the myoma because it requires a lot of frequent changes. Rather than, I prefer to use the tenoculum in some cases. Here on the one side, I try to make the cut it properly. I will lift up that. And this is the area of the uterine artery. Can you appreciate?
Yes.
I enter
yes.
retroperitoneally, and even though sometimes I go for the ureteric tunnel, I dissect the uterine artery, and it's maybe it's a Okabaya space. Can you appreciate this one?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
So sometimes it also gives the clue related to ureter. Unchu kar diya bhai Raju. Abadla. Abaju. Opposite side. Okay. So we try to make the naked on the one side. Okay. And we try to make the flush to the
so now you have the vaginal manipulator inside.
Yes, now. So I think most probably this is the part of the ureter what I previously saw. This is the ureter.
Yes.
Can
yes.
you appreciate?
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now it can be appreciated very well.
So I think you need the patience in such kind of the cases. Never jump directly because it's a
seems to be a little dilated, a little
hydrodilated. I cut these fibrotic portions. Okay, can you appreciate
yes,
this one?
Sir. Yes, sir, absolutely.
So I think the multiple approach, it's a missionary like the school in the endometriosis. You require a lot of multiple approach. Okay? Now the also I look related to this uterine artery because this anatomy it's never changed most probably. Water is always below. This is the one of the dictating. Silas is telling many times. And at the end, look here. Now this is the uterine, okay? Can you appreciate? This is the uterine yes. and water is always below the breech.
Absolutely, yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
So this is the uterine. This is the also nodules. We try to make the remove it. This is the whole nodules, okay? In the
yes,
broad
sir.
Ligament.
Yes.
But before that, I try to make the clear it here. This one is the nodules, and this is the whole uterine artery. Now you appreciate, okay?
Yes, sir.
And this is the whole nodules. I remove it first. It is only hard tissue. I show you, Jyoti. 1 minute, because I need the lot of. Otherwise, I do on the spinal level. This case is different, so I need the focus. And also we do the cystoscopy in this case. Lift up it, opposite side layer. V-lock 30 ready. So now it's clear, this is the whole kidney from above to here. This is the middle parietal space, okay?
Yes, sir.
And if you go here, then you find out the holy plane. What we done in the particularly cases of the colon resections. But second important part we look related to, this is the hypogastric. Now can you appreciate?
Yes, sir.
And I think this is the whole area. but we couldn't require now this one. Now we focus, this is the kidney, this is the internal iliac artery. Can you appreciate this one is the internal iliac artery? This is anterior division of umbilical ligament. This is the vesical artery. Can you appreciate this one? This is, yes, now sir. You should be stretch it. This is the vesical artery. Okay? This is, yes, anterior sir. Division. This is the vesicle. This is what we dissected. It's the uterine artery. Sometimes we find out it's the uterine artery. Okay? Yes. And this is the ureter. This is the deep vein. Can you appreciate? This is the deep, yes, vein.
Sir. Yes.
Okay, this is the deep vein. And if we here, this is the one vein is crossing between the ureter. This is the one vein is here. Second vein, most probably we find out the here. Okay? And if you look that now, you check the... Now we clear the everything because this case is pelvic kidney, and if the any kinking of the ureter is happened, it creates the problem,
yes,
for the
heart. So you will be sacrificing the uterine artery, right?
No, I think in this cases couldn't require it. But okay, any the fibrotic portion over this ureter, we clear it.
Okay, sir.
Now I show the peristalsis. Also, I try to look here. Okay?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay? Peristalsis?
Yes, sir.
Excellent?
Absolutely wonderful.
Now, this is the whole chunk of adenoma. Later on, we see. Before that, we look here. This is the... here also, we look related to, because this is all our fibrotic portions. Okay? So, we go enter retroperitoneally. Lift up it, lift up it. I see. Dr. Lakshman Kheria with me. He is the GI surgeon from Apollo Hospital, but he is heading our GI department at Mayflower. He is the liver transplant specialist. And Dr. Sanjeev Upadhyay is the very good dear friend of mine. We study together from the first MBBS. And he is our chief anesthetist. In these cases also, we don't want to compromise. We look the ureter and we remove. This is the whole fibrotic portions. So now again, here most probably it's the shifting of the ureter medially. Barabar?
Yeah. Dr. Sanjay Patel, there are a few queries from the audience. Yes. I will read out the queries. They are more or less something parallel to them. A lot of queries are there regarding the intra-op or pre-op imaging which can be done. So to delineate,
I think basically I don't like the imaging stent, Rajesh. So always I try to make the prefer to find out and dissect. Sometimes it's needed. There is no bravery in the medical field. Bahaduri ka koi model nahi hota. But in some cases, I think if required, then definitely we look for the illumination stent. Here, this is the ureter. Can you appreciate?
Yes, very nicely seen.
And this is the all fibrotic portions. I try to make the remove it.
Yeah. Another query is, somebody is asking, this is the, you are using 3D right now at your place for this particular surgery and whether 3D helps.
Yes, absolutely, Rajesh. This is a very good answer. Even so though I use the 3D Karlstrom's camera, but even though I am planned for the Rubina, this is the new 3D with the 55-inch TV, and it's the, even though I not experienced, I told to the stores people for the demo, but even the Dr. Divyesh Shukla has taken it, and I think we received the message. It's considered to be one of the best system. This is the all are involved. This is the Rajesh. This is the posterior endometriotic nodules. This is most probably the parametric involvement.
Yes.
Okay, Rajesh?
Yes.
And so that's why very important to we check the ureter priorly. This is the ureter. Always I am telling in the endometriosis, ureter have the pseudocyst in cases of the endometriosis. So this is ureter, okay? And this is the all fibrotic portions. It's involved. Sometimes if you couldn't remove it, such kind of the things. patient may be presented with the hydronephrosis. It's very common. Even though I tell you, in our institute, every day we look, the patient is presented with the hydronephrosis and hydroureter in the endometriosis. Now you look the kinking of ureter here. Can you appreciate? This is the vein. This is the vein. Can you appreciate? This is the vein.
Yes, sir. Yes,
so
sir.
I think I try to make the cut from the here. The major part, I think, we try to make the zero disease-free pelvis, but in the endometriosis, sometimes it's also not possible. So we prefer to do the optimizing surgery. Always I am telling, in okay?
Everybody's talking, many people are talking about peritoneectomy, like removing a lot
yes,
of peritoneum.
Yes, I think it's very important.
So this is something like
in the such cases also be required. Yes. Here it's a fibrotic lesion over this ureter, and that's why the ureter is compromised with the trenches, okay?
Yes.
Sometimes the fiber by fiber and in bulk, it's not possible in the all cases is the total peritonectomy or in bulk block dissection in such kind of the cases. This is also fibrotic peritoneum over it. Rajesh, might be you. So I think I remove this one.
Okay.
Sorry.
What setting are you using on the harmonic?
This is always on the higher side, level 5.
They should come up with another setting, Sanjay Patel setting, so that the harmonic automatically dissects in the correct plane.
I think, Rajesh,
it's an excellent dissection, and throughout the frozen pelvis which you have cleared off, you have entered into the exact correct location and the exact correct plane. It's really creditable. Hats off to you.
Thank
that
you,
is
Rajesh.
Why he's master of endometriosis all over the country. And
so this is the parametrium involvement. So before I remove this one, this is the whole affected lateral parametrium. So first I remove this one, then I get the good plane. Further I more dissected the ureter. So if you look that this ovarian tube is good, and we I think couldn't look for the, because majority time the victim of the ureter is at the level of ureteric tunnel. So again there is a lot of fibrosis. Again there is a lot of fibrosis here. Can you appreciate this one?
Yes.
And
yes.
Here might be I injured the vein, but I boldly cut it because we have to have the do it.
The whole surgery is being done boldly actually.
This is your greatness, Rajesh. Okay, so I think I boldly cut this one because it's very important. And another one important part, always remove this one. This is very important. Try to make the parallel to the ovary and remove the all the fibrotic portion and give the free space. In our center, I tell you, 30% is patient to carry the natural pregnancy after such kind of the surgery. So I think you have to have the properly remove the all the nodules. Jaise barish aate hai aur patte khulne lagte hai, the same way, if you remove the all the tensions over this fallopian tube and ovary, I think it's work well. Not only the just restore the anatomy, it's not the only part, but you have to have the get the good mobility of the ovary, Rajesh.
Yes.
You not yes. only the to restore the tube ovary relations, but you have to have the get the good mobility of the ovary and fallopian tube. Now you look that this fallopian tube is here, okay? So it's easily pick up it, and this ovary is now not rigid. Still there is some adhesions, puckering is here near to the ovarian ligament. This is the nodules, okay?
You are called it once ovarian adenomyosis.
I think we also commonly remember that. Any fibrotic things in the ovary, also we try to make the remove it. Further, I look here because the ureter is now clear, Rajesh.
Yes.
But here I feel there is some fibrotic portions. I cut it, whatever it is. Most probably is the vein.
सर ऑडियंस का बीपी बढ़ रहा है.
यू हैव टू हैव द डू इट राजेश. Whatever you feel that this is the first surgery for the endometriosis.
And normally,
this is the perimetrium involvement. Okay, Rajesh?
I am sure that the entire audience is having their blood pressure going up.
No, but I think this is the perimetrium involvement. We couldn't leave it. Okay, Elisa.
The patient has been counseled for ureteric injury, all those bowel injury, everything counseling has been done.
How many time I think I left with me? Still this one is the only 1 hour. I need the other.
From what we have been informed is that your session is supposed to be there for another 15 minutes.
Okay. So I think, can I start with this adenoma resection? So I remove this all the nodules, okay? This is the, I am splitting the nodules. Can you appreciate, Rajesh? Here, yes, I think, yes, we enter in the denominator space here. And I splitting the nodules. So this is the part of the what the MRI show. This is the 2.5 to 1. This is the all the nodules. Okay.
Yes.
Can you appreciate? This is the part, yes, of the whole nodules.
This is the part of
tissue. Appreciate. होते रहेगा, but definitely the entire audience is appreciating you. Dr. Nahata has sent me a WhatsApp message to kindly tell you that you are appreciated. Dr. Kiran Kohelo has sent me a message to specifically appreciate you for your clean dissection. So a lot of messages are coming in. Very clean, very bold surgery.
So this is Rajesh, part of the colorectal nodule.
You are on the uterine serosa, sir?
No, I think I split the nodules from the here and I take with this uterus, okay? And if, yes, you look, this chalky material remain inside. So I think later on, I think if I bring the nodules with the colon, then I put the rectal probe and I save it. If this one is I split and take with the vagina and cervix, then such way, because it's a easy way. You need a lot of variation in the endometriosis surgery. And this is the hypogastric now. Can you appreciate? This is the hypogastric,
yes,
now here.
Very, very clean,
okay,
and very nice.
So I don't want to dissect and show the hypogastric now, because if I pick up the nerve, if you injure the 1 mm of nerve, then it's required the another 1 week to heal this one. So I think this is the part of the whole colorectal nodule.
Yes.
Okay.
Very nicely it is seen and appreciated.
And this is the whole rectal tube is now clear. Okay.
Yes.
Now the another part, it's if you look it here, this is totally axis rotation of the uterus is here. Okay, this is the part of the healthy uterus here. This is fallopian tube. Whatever the advanced, this is tube is always better. I show dynamo. And this is the whole deviation of the colon, deviation of the bladder toward, yes, the on the left side. Rajesh.
Very true.
Okay, so my baby, this is the healthy tissue, okay, I feel that, okay,
yes,
but this is the whole adenomyotic tissue, so I cut, okay, it. Dye test karo, tinaculum do chalo.
But it's not too significant enough to cut it off, or do you want to?
No, really I think this is the localized adenoma, Rajesh, here, this is the part of the localized adenoma, I show,
yes,
you. This is the whole part of the localized adenoma.
Yes.
And this is the surface.
Okay, that part is normal.
Now you feel that this is the bulging of this one. Can you appreciate?
Yes.
So I work related to adenoma, and I think also I standardize related to technique of adenoma. This is the all our endometriotic tissue. This is ovarian ligament. Okay.
Yes.
This is the another nodules tissue.
So you have not used vasopressin, you have not used,
yes,
much of cautery, and you have not used any suction.
No. No need of that, Rajesh. You are in the right plan, you are in the correct plan. No need of that. The tissue is created plan for us, Rajesh. If you,
yes,
fall in love with the tissue, the tissue is already created plan with you.
Yes.
Yes, it's good.
From what we understand, you have one midline post suprapubic.
I think one of the dictum is the fiber to fiber dissection.
Yes, I think for every surgery that is important to be able to dissect well, to be able to remain in the correct avascular plane.
Rajesh, this is not joke. If definitely I tell you, if you fall in love with the tissue, tissue is created pathway for you. It's the not matter related to understanding the anatomy, not matter related to anything. This is the blind game of love. That's it.
Sir, ovary is still slightly adherent. Would you like to feed further?
Right? No, I think so, this is the physiological adhesion. Never remove it. Okay?
Yes.
So I think this is also the puckering and kinking of the tube, okay? The small, yes, small things is very important. Now you realize that this is the fallopian tube, Rajesh?
Yes.
Okay? This is the kink. This is the whole kinking of the tube.
Anterior adhesion, yes.
So now I create the whole tube is clear. Absolutely. And now, yes, I cut it here because this is the corneal, the dye is coming from the cornu. But most probably, the whatever the advanced disease, tube is always better.
Yes. What is the bluish coloration coming up?
This is the, I think, what the, we separated the cornu from the here, okay? We remove the
tumor. Are you injecting anything, methylene blue or something from below?
Something from below where?
No, this is the coloration blue. Is slightly dark and bluish.
But so I think, Rajesh, I personally feel that this is not a much more adenomyotic tissue. This is the normal surface of the uterus, okay? Serosal surface. This is all, yes, our damaged tissue and this is adenomyotic. If we corrected, yes, this one fallopian tube, there is no much more. This is the healthy tissue. I feel that, okay?
Yes.
And here this is the little bit adhesions. Again I cut it. Still there is a, this is the recto-vaginal plate, okay?
Nice.
We also show the technique of butterfly technique, and we have to have the remove this recto-vaginal plate, okay?
Okay.
What is that butterfly technique?
I think I already put on the YouTube. This is our Mayflower butterfly technique, and maybe this is the involvement of the upper vagina, Rajesh.
Yes.
So if needed, I open the vagina, no problem, and then I suture it.
Jyoti, if you see his butterfly technique, that is a technique which gives you butterflies in your stomach just to watch him.
I not heard the. This is the part of the colorectal plate. Can you appreciate? This is the all there, all our chalky things remain inside. Can you appreciate?
Yes.
So this is the part of the. Look here. This is the chalky collections.
Hello. Good evening, Patel sir.
Yes. Very good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Pandit here.
Yes, Pandit sir. How are you? Fine.
Yeah, sir, enjoying your surgery. It's always a great surgical treat to watch your surgery. And everybody is in love with you.
Thank you. So yeah, I think now most of the things I clear it because there is no residual urine here, okay? Here there is no residual urine. This is the. Now I suture this column, okay? Because some serosal injury I created 2-0 up.
Do you think if you do not suture, will it cause any problem? Because
I think better you suture it because we face the one time, we find out that there is a small thermal injury of the serosal surface of the colon, and this patient is presented with the Rajesh with the fecal peritonitis. So I think we look. So we realize that if any time if you feel that there is a muscularis or serosal small injury, better you spend the 2 minutes more. Okay?
Yes.
I think left behind, you feel that you do something for this colon. Okay? And better you take the one or two stitches is enough.
But would the burying stitch make any, have any specific advantage? If you're only going to bury that part, it's not about cutting off that ischemic area and then suturing again.
Rajesh, now we remove this stiomas because yes. Already we mobilized from the above. This is our ghost piece, we take it.
For any tissue to remove, do you prefer to put in an endomag?
Yes, always, because the scar endometriosis is much more higher. And now yes. You look that, even the previously I also formed that there is a nothing remain inside. Okay, Rajesh?
Yes.
In spite of that, I couldn't cut it. I spoke with the, even though in the audience.
Yes.
But in spite of that, first you look the ureter. This is the dictive for the endometriosis.
Yes.
But a very important is the abnormal renal vein, I show you in these cases, because we do the lot of nephrectomy, Rajesh, in endometriosis. Yes.
Okay.
Even the tomorrow I also saw the one case of the colon resection and associated with the, we do the nephrectomy because it's a non-functioning kidney. The same case is also I operated before 5 years back, and then we do the, this is the extrinsic involvement of the ureter, and then we do the IVF. This patient is carried the twins pregnancy, and another 5 years later on presented with the non-functioning kidney. So
you are doing the nephrectomy yourself?
Yes. We have the Lakshman with us. This is our guru, I think. We do everything.
No, but it would be nice to know that you are doing it yourself, so that we know that okay.
I think you require the. You joined with the other faculty, those who master in the particular field, and I think you take the learn the something. If you look here, this is the whole kidney, but I think the vein is here. Okay, can you understand? Can you appreciate?
Yes.
This is the most probably multiple. If you dissect further more, then you find out the two artery and two vein. Audience is interested, then we show the everything. Majority time it's the two artery and two vein. Sucharami.
An absolutely inoperable case has been managed so effectively, cleanly, and within an hour's time actually.
I think it's depend upon your experience, Rajesh, I tell you. Because previously, if we started this work quite long back, in around the era of 2000.
Sanjay, your voice is a bit low.
Rajesh, actually, we started this work, retroperitoneal, that people is telling me mad. People is tell me he is so crazy related to endometriosis, and that's why he do the lot of aggressive work and everything. So people is not agree with me related to this part at that time. So Rajesh, this is the small thermal injury, okay?
Yes. It's
small muscularis. So in spite of that, we leave the left behind. Suture it.
The rectum, sir. Is it the rectum? No?
Yes. This is the whole rectal tube.
Serosa
This is the muscularis portion, okay? This is the small muscularis tear, okay?
Yes.
Can you appreciate?
Yes, it is so seen quite clearly.
So better you suture it.
Don't the
leave
transmission picture quality
and I also show
good.
The at the end, the picture quality is good.
Yes, surgical picture quality is good. Surgery is even better. Only thing is, I think your audio is a little low. You need to have the mic closer to your
mouth.
Because of the
time constraint,
we increase the volume.
Now it's clear?
Yes.
So Rajesh, this is the also rectal tube. This is the Akalu arm.
Sir, because of this small tear, would you like to keep her a little longer fasting, or you would just wait for bowel sounds to come?
I think after 6 hours later on, I start the oral in this case. Take the good muscularis chunk, okay?
Yes.
If this one is a big rent, then I took the transverse. But it's a small rent, if you take the vertical, it makes doesn't difference. Because there is some chances of the stricture if you suture vertically. What the Lakshman has taught me.
Hello.
Eh?
Hello, sir. Sorry to interrupt you. We are changing the audio to other center. So thank you so much, Patel sir.
Thank you, Pandit. Thank you, Pandit. Thank you, Rajesh. And Pandit, one minute, please. I thanks to the Dr. Krishna Kumar because yes. I think he gives this Dr. Pandit and Krishna Kumar giving this opportunity to perform this case in this March 2022. And I think wish you all the best, both of you, for the grand success of this year. And I think in the future we do the better and better program like this one.
Sanjay Katel.
Yes, sir.
Take 5 more minutes. Fantastic. Thank you so much for agreeing to be here with me. And I'm sure your morning blessings which you gave, it is going on well. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, Dr. Krishna Kumar, for this opportunity, and Dr. Sanjay Patel for the brilliant surgery that you have shown. It was really worth sitting and watching you operate.
Thank you, Rajesh. Thank you, Rajesh.
So
thank you, Rajendra, Nagendra, and yes, Dr. Jyoti, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
You are
thank you. It's a pleasure being.
Sir, your video will continue as a VIP picture. We will keep you watching.